Everyone, welcome to round one. We've won the roll, so we're gonna go ahead and play first. This hand is okay. We've got some pretty good four drops and removal, double black, so all we need are a few other lands and we'll be fine. Granted, we're gonna be drawing cards like Swordwise Centaur, probably first. So that'll only go to sweeten the game. So what we're gonna do is, would we like to mulligan? No. And we'll see what we're playing against. So, we're gonna go ahead and lead off with swamp, ship. And it looks like another swamp. So, Cavern Land Pads is probably gonna be sideboarded out. Oh, well, it's not Swordwise Centaur, but it's about as close to it as we can get. At least it'll do something later on in the game when we draw our second and green. And land. No. Okay, well, if we draw land, then we can get this bad boy. It's gonna be a Servant of Timurit, which I kind of want to use removal on. Land? No. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and discard Mortals Resolve. Let's see. No, I don't think we're going to discard Mortals Resolve. That'll be good. We can discard Humbler of Mortals. All we need to do is draw land. We draw a forest, then we're in action. But until then, we're going to get our face bashed in. Crone Phalanx. Well, this guy is simply a 3/3 vigilance. And so we'll go ahead and use that on him. Because why not? Boom. Look at that. Hopefully, this harpy remains is good for us. I really want to be able to have a forest so we can play Nyx Infusion to save it from something. And Supply Line Cranes. That guy's pretty big. Land? No, it's an Oathsworn. Well, we can take this opportunity to play Nyx Infusion on something. We'll go ahead and play it on the Supply Line Cranes because we're going to be attacking with our Insatiable Harpy at some point, and I don't really want to attack a 2/2 into a 2/4, so go ahead and put that there. And we can eventually get a bunch of stuff onto the battlefield to the point where he will not be able to attack with Servant of Timurit, and we'll thus have to spend mana to regenerate in order to get the drain. So we'll have to make him work a little bit harder for his damage. No creatures, huh? Well, here we go. Let's get the show on the road, as they say. I can only hope that we draw a forest next turn so we can have this Mortals Resolve going. Otherwise, we're going to be racing two against three, which isn't really that great. And now he's drawn his second black, so he could potentially play Asphyxiate or a Frigga's Cure. Yeah, this is definitely not Divine Verdict if I've ever seen one, so could be Battlewise Valor also. I'm not gonna really jump into that in front of that train. I'm gonna take this opportunity to go give myself. Oh no, is this a Sip of Hemlock? Shrike Harpy. Well, put two plus one counters on Shrike Harpy, yes. Don't really want to sack my guy. Ah, there we go. So, what is going to happen now? Well, we're going to play Golden Hind. Or we can play Pharaoh's Band Centaurs. I actually like playing the Centaurs here. Because that's going to moat this guy, at least for the moment. And then we can deal with this next turn, or his Battlewise Valor, or whatever he's got. Hopefully, we can just draw another land, and he has Battlewise Valor instead of Verdict. So I want to hopefully draw a land so I can bestow, and then another land so I can Mortals Resolve and play something else. So we're going to go ahead and play this here. Looks like he probably does have Divine Verdict. Either that or he's just getting the free point of damage from the Inspired trigger. And so this is going to get pretty tricky because he can prevent us from gaining life if he blocks in Divine Verdicts and attacks with just a Shrike Harpy. So there's the land. Yeah, so I think what I have to do is just play this, bestow the emissary here, and attack, or don't attack, because if he has verdict, then I'd rather have him use it on his turn. But if he has something like, I can't really see, do anything about him having God's willing. So I think what we want to do is just play around what we can, which is going to be a pump spell. So we'll go ahead and see what this does. Hopefully he has Battle-Eyes Valor and not Divine Verdicts. So we'll just play this, pass the turn. Oh no, he's got Farika's Cure. Bioblight. And that's gonna do it. So we'll go ahead and move on, as it were. Man, that sucks. Okay, so we can probably take this Cavern Lamphead out, and I think we can probably play something like, let's see, what did he have? Well, we don't know how many flyers he has, so the sky reaping is going to be variable. If we're taking out Lamphad, then Oathsworn gets a lot worse. Actually don't mind this since we have got some green creatures. I just don't really see anything that I actually want to bring in.